What's up YouTube? So today on my desk I have this power amplifier that I'm working on. So when I just started working on, I thought perhaps I should get out a camera and document the process of trying to resurrect it, and I see if I can make it get it back to proper working order. So before I became Afro-Rack in my previous life about 7 years ago, I was an audio technician, sound engineer in Kampala, setting up for bands and all kinds of sound systems. And that's where I found devices like amplifiers and picked interest in really finding out how stuff like this works. At the time, I think there were not many people that were really good with fixing this kind of stuff, which piqued my interest in learning electronics. So on the bench is this Martin Brother Audio MA3600 professional power amplifier. It's a high quality professional amplifier. It's not Chinese, not made of Chinesium. So it is a class H amplifier, I believe, but pretty much that's just a class AB with switching rails. So what happens is it normally sits at around 69 positive and negative, but then when there's a transient or the output is about to maximize all the voltage, you know, to approach the rail, then what happens is that it has FETs, MOSFETs, or field effect transistors that switch the rail to 136 positive and negative. So you can imagine all that voltage potential of up to 236 voltage DC across these two heatsinks. So this is why you have to take this caution very seriously. In fact, I'll put for you footage of many years ago when, you know, one of my probes slipped and shorted something and a big bang or flash went off as all that energy is dissipated. So you have to really be careful, because if you don't know what you're doing, this thing is going to send you to an early or premature death.
You really have to be very careful. In fact, I'll show you the capacitor discharging. You don't want that to happen.
So one other safety feature is this incandescent bulb, which is wired in series with the power to the amplifier. So in case there's a short circuit here or any other problem, let's say the transistors on the output short out and are trying to pull a lot of current, then that current instead goes through that bulb and makes it light up, so that energy is dissipated in the bulb instead of destroying this amplifier. So one other thing to note with this amplifier is that the fans do not come on immediately when you turn it on. Many amplifiers have fans come on immediately on power on, but this one, it has to first warm up when there's need for more ventilation, and that's when the fans kick in. So as you could hear, the music is distorting. There's clearly a problem. But before we even start diagnosing what the problem is, it's always good if you can find a service manual so that you follow what the circuit looks like and see where everything is and what's happening. But unfortunately, some of these amplifiers are made in Japan, China, and some of those companies don't share, like many companies today, service manuals. No one wants the stuff repaired anymore. So I spent a couple of days to drop this, which I believe is the schematic of the most important parts of this amplifier. My plan of action and the reason I really put this schematic together is to understand where the signal path is. So for example, if I'm tracing the signal, it's supposed to come through this transistor and then it's fed through this VAS, and then the signal goes through the biasing into the output. So if I generate a sine wave on the input of this transistor, I can trace it, you know, and see eventually where it's distorted at what stage, and I know what stage of the amplifier is not functioning well. Okay, so the fun part begins. This is my oscilloscope. It is a very incredible measuring, testing tool, but it is not cheap. I had to save up and afford one, and I've had this only for the last 2 years, yet I've done electronics for so many years. But of course, you can always use the very reliable multimeter, which is cheap. It goes a long way, but this takes things to the next level because you can visualize a lot of things that you want to test. So I decided to pull out the board. I didn't want to deal with the high voltages on the amplifier all the time. Now, power amplifiers have a high voltage section and a low voltage section normally. So this is the low powered section. It's a dual power supply, and this is responsible for things like these ICs. You know, there's a couple of them. And I'm getting this power around 12 volts plus and minus from this old computer power supply that I have right there. So on the setup, I also have a signal generator running on my phone, which is running a sine wave of that frequency through this amplifier, and it comes in here. So I'm trying to make sure that the signal is okay before it reaches the high voltage section. And this has also helped me trace the signal flow in here to make sure everything is okay before the high voltages are applied. So this is the circuit that I've been able to trace on the inputs. This is a common operational amplifier used for audio, and this is driving channel 1 and channel 2. So on the input here, which you see, it goes to this operational amp on channel 1. This is channel 1, this is channel 2. And then this op amp drives these ports or potentiometers or watt changes in brackets, the volume. But for power amplifiers, it's so actually not a volume but input sensitivity. Yeah, you could read up about that. So the signal then comes to, there's supposed to be a relay here, but that relay is missing, and I don't think I can find one right now. So I just bridged the gaps, but I guess this is also a protection mechanism that if something is wrong with the amplifier, then it can turn off the input, but that's not a big problem right now. So I've been able to trace the signal through here, and the signal is good up to the part where it joins these high voltage amplifiers, high voltage transistors. So I could show you a bit of that. So like I said earlier, I have a sine wave of 1.9K that's coming in from my frequency generator, and it looks something like this beautiful sine wave. So if I'm probing through my circuit, I want to see a stable sine wave, which is this beautiful, and you know, no distortions, no funny, strange things happening. And guess what? As I was tracing my sine wave up to the bases of my transistors, look at what happens. This is the beauty of the oscilloscope. I seem to have lost a portion of the sine wave. So I'm having only the negative portion, and the positive portion seems to have disappeared. Okay, so I've fixed back the positive supply of the circuit here. I'd kicked it around and hadn't noticed, so it was not connected. And I want to show you again what the input looks like right now. A beautiful sine wave. And if I go back to the same place we were previously, we see we have a beautiful sine wave. Yeah, that one. Beautiful sine wave. So as per now, I can say the part of the circuit that I traced here is okay. The signal is okay up to at least it going in the differential part of the amplifier, which is what I'm going to deal with next. So it's another day of repairs. Are working on this project, but I'm determined to really find out what's wrong with this for the sake of my own learning, and if it helps someone out there learn something or be inspired to try stuff like this, then I'll be more than glad to do this. So I'm feeding a sine wave, as I said, again in this transistor, and we expect a sine wave to come out with higher amplitude out of this part of the circuit. So we're going to try and see how that works out. You see on the scope, this is the sine wave in the collector of the first transistor. We can also look at actually the sine wave on the differential part here, in this part, and you can see it right here. Even looks much better. So the sine wave is then fed into this voltage amplification stage, and on its output we should also expect a good healthy sine wave, and the output is right here. I need to adjust the level. I mean my hand is here. I can't adjust that, so I need to first adjust the scale here. Now look at that. This is the signal that we're having coming out of the collector here. Now if you're keen, you're noticing that the bottom part of the sine wave has been clipped, because it's supposed to, you know, go up and also go down, but it's stopping and being clipped somewhere in the middle. So this transistor is connected to the positive rail through the emitter, as you can see, and the more it conducts through this path is the more it pulls the signal upwards towards the positive rail. So I believe this part of this transistor is working perfectly well, but if you trace the signal or the current, it then goes through these two LEDs and it crosses to the negative part of the amplifier. Now on this side we also have a similar VAS, voltage amplification stage, and I probed here. I have, you know, a healthy signal, but out of here, as you can see, this is connected to the negative. The more it conducts, it's supposed to pull the signal towards the bottom, but we're missing that. Now the challenge with these amplifiers is that everything is DC coupled, so a problem in one section of the amplifier will present itself in another and will confuse you. It could be an issue here and show itself here. I'm beginning to believe that the issue is actually not in this stage of the amplifier, but is within the biasing, because you see these paths go on to this part of the amplifier. So I believe there's something around here that is stopping this bottom part from working, which I need to find out. And I'm also beginning to question myself why these LEDs are not working. These LEDs are here on the board, and I believe they're supposed to be indicators that you have enough current flowing through the voltage amplification stage to go to drive the output. So my next course of action, I'm going to try and remove this connection from here, from the what is called the VBE multiplier. I'm going to remove that connection and see if conditions in this part of the circuit improve, and I see if I get the bottom part of the signal. So if I get the bottom half of the signal again showing up, then I'll know the issue is not here. This is okay. I'm disturbing this part for nothing. I need to look at this stage of the amplifier. So I've disconnected this part of the circuit so that I isolate this, the VAS stage, from the VBE multiplier. And look at the board, guys. These lights just came on. So basically, if we look here, it means that we have a current flowing from the upper part, from the positive, into the negative part of the circuit. So if you look at the board, I also changed this trimmer here. Yep, somewhere there. I put another trimmer and it seems to be somewhere in the biasing parts or on the input of this differential transistor. But I want to go back and probe on the circuit and trace the signal and see what it looks like right now, since I have some current flowing. Okay, so previously we looked at the output from this VAS stage and the positive side was working, but the negative side was missing. And I've attached a probe here and you can still see the same thing on the oscilloscope. But I want to adjust this potentiometer, which I added. I hope it's in focus. And then as I adjust it, please look at the bottom part of the waveform. See that?
So basically, if I adjust it, it adjusts the output of the first stage. And look at that, that is almost perfect. So this excites me that I'm going to find out what's wrong with this amplifier. This is an almost perfect sine wave. If you look at the bottom here, you see that the peak-to-peak voltage is around 200 and maybe 210-220. And that makes sense because the power supply that we are running is 124, which is 124 positive and 124 negative. So the potential is 248 supply. So if we're clipping at 220, then it means right now we've balanced or have balanced this stage, and that's how it's supposed to be performing. So any other problems that I have further downstream, and I'm going to look at this part of the circuit and see if what is causing problems here, and then I know the output is okay. There's no issue with these outputs, and if we find what's happening with the VBE multiplier circuit, I assure you that we're going to be having a working amplifier. This is the channel that I'm working on. I've removed it and cleaned it with alcohol a bit. The circuit board was very dirty. So I've been probing around, and if I can bring it closer, right here, there's a diode, which I believe is a Zener diode, and right here. And that beep you hear means that it is shorted. This capacitor is shorted as well, but I don't know if it's the capacitor or the Zener that's shorted, but there's a short around here which I need to investigate and see. And indeed, it is shorted, as you can hear. Okay, so it's yet another day of me pulling hairs out of my head trying to figure out what's happening on this amplifier. So the diagram that you see here now is me trying to trace what's happening on this part of the circuit which I'm working on right now. This also contributes to the biasing of the output stage. And this is what I've managed to trace so far, to see how the current moves from the upper rail. There's supposed to be a current that's moving downwards into this biasing circuit, which pushes the biasing and the signal into the output stage. You have to respect the people who design this stuff. I'm telling you, you have to respect those human beings. They're quite special. So if you look keenly here, you notice there's a burnt part also on this board, and this connects to the ground of the LMC555 timer chip. And this happened because there's a resistor, this which I'd put some time back because I don't have an SMD part, and it was lying here, and it opened up somewhere and it shorted and burnt this part of the circuit. So I'm still finding some burnt components, and I'm going to try and find as much as I can. And after that, I'll power it again and see if the behavior of the circuit has improved. Now, these fuses I've also noticed are blown, and these are the fuses from the high power supply which go to the output stage, but fortunately the transistors are not blown. These are very expensive devices, so the fuses did their work, and I have a blown fuse there and a blown fuse there. So let me keep probing and see if I can solve the problem that's happening here and eventually have current flowing, because we don't have current for biasing the output, so the output cannot function basically right now. So I put back this board in the amplifier. I've basically replaced those resistors which I showed you which are burnt, and the challenge I was having was that every time I connected this part of the amplifier to this, then the signal was collapsing. Something was happening here. So this is my dummy load, by the way, 50 watts 4 ohms. It's acting as a load to the amplifier, so basically it's in the space of a loudspeaker because I don't want to make noise for the neighbors. This is the sine wave generator again, and I want to probe this part of the circuit that we've been working on, and I see
if we have signal actually going to the place we didn't have before. And look at that on the oscilloscope, we have a sine wave. So if we also probe on the output of the amplifier there, I also have the same sine wave. Look at that. So it means I'm one step closer to fixing this amplifier. But if you look around the edges of the sine wave, I have a lot of noise going on. So I do not know what's the cause of that noise, but I'm going to try and find out. So the remaining part basically is to just find where the noise is coming from and adjust, you know, the crossover distortion on the board. And hopefully we'll have it playing some nice music. Okay, so it's yet another day of working on this project. I'm quite determined to see it through and resurrect this amplifier, give it back its life. So I was scavenging through my parts and I found these SMD components which I bought from Mauser some years back, and they have, I'd actually bought them for this amplifier. But that was years back. I was not able to fix it. But now I found I have some of the parts that I need. Some of these SMD resistors, which you see there. There are some transistors, but fortunately I don't have any burnt transistors on the board. But for the other parts I can't find, then I have to scavenge them off boards like this, which I have, you know, lying somewhere. Some of these have SMD resistors and, you know, some stuff which I can use for other projects. So I don't throw away stuff like this. So I've put all the parts that I found which are burnt on both boards. I've actually worked on both channels and I've powered the amplifier. So now I'm feeding again that sine wave into the amplifier. And I want to show you what's happening at the output. These are the outputs, the two channels. And if you look at the scope, look at that, guys. I have a clean sine wave going through. And that is channel number one, and this is channel number two. I also have a clean sine wave going through. So I'm very excited, and I believe that I've fixed this amplifier, but the real test is playing music through a loudspeaker and I hear what it sounds like. So that is going to be my next step. I'm really excited about this. Let me play music through there and I hear if there's something that comes out there that sounds good. Okay, so this is the moment of truth, guys, or the moment of lies. I don't know what's going to happen, but let's play some music through and see what happens. Okay, so the final test that I'm doing is to make sure this amplifier has no crossover distortion. So crossover distortion normally shows up at the crossover point. Here is a crossover point when the signal is moving from the negative to the positive. And if the output of the, this is the output where there are the power transistors, the last stage of the amplifier. If it's not properly biased or getting the right current to switch on the transistors, then you're going to have distortion right there, and it's not pleasant. It doesn't sound good, and the music wouldn't sound good coming out of this amplifier. But I seem not to have any distortion. I trimmed it out. There are trimmers here. There's a trimmer. I think I showed you those previously. Behind that connector there is that trim pot, and it's on both channels and also on this channel. And also there's other trimmers on this board which I showed you some time back, which, you know, are all part of the biasing of this amplifier. So now I think everything is properly biased, everything is properly trimmed, the signal is looking good, and the amplifier is ready to go out to play music in the real world. Oh.